content of the following program is not intended to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, treatment, or cure. Always consult your physician or a health professional with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Want to go higher, baby? You're in the right place. You're listening to One Life Radio. This is Bernadette with Diamond Gray. I've got Lexi Brinkley in studio with me, Aviana Berrientos, and DeWone Bennett. Hey, guys. How's it going?
I'm great. I'm living my best life.
Are you?
Ooh, yes.
I love it.
Well, you know, I was talking to a friend of mine last night, Isaac Montemary, and we were just talking. We hadn't talked in a long time. He's a surgeon in Florida.
Okay.
He used to work with me at Pizza Patron
Wow.
back at the Mesquite location that's been shut down for many, many years, but it was a second location. But he said, you're only living if you're living out of your comfort zone. And I've heard, phrases or, similar to that, but it's really true.
It is.
It's
very true. Making sure that you're doing things that make you comfortable. When you spend too much of your life trying to please everyone else, then you're essentially going down a trap that you'll never, ever be able to fulfill.
I'm an adrenaline junkie, I think, because I love, I like to feel alive in the world. I got to be doing something. And, I was talking with another friend, actually a new friend. His name is Sean, and he's a guy that ran into a traffic accident.
Wow.
A couple of weeks ago.
And you made a friend.
And he's
out
a new
of it.
Friend. That's so nice.
He's such a nice guy. And so he and his wife live, I think, out in Forney. But anyway, so, I mean, the art of being kind and understanding and gracious to one another is slowly eroding in this country.
Yes, it is.
It really is. So we were, I was coming from, I was on Munger.
Okay.
From, I can't remember where I was coming from. I think from my singing lesson. Anyway, it was on a Thursday night a couple of weeks ago, and he accidentally rear-ended me. Well, I didn't lose my mind. I didn't get angry. That kind of stuff just happens. It happens,
yes, it does.
Anyway, we exchanged information. I was a little bit in shock just because I wasn't ready for it. I don't think you ever really are. But my car, my Subaru, which I just love my Crosstrek, it took it like a champ.
Now, you were okay, right?
Oh, I was fine.
Okay.
Barely visible marks.
Okay. They say it's one of the safest cars on the market.
Yes,
and
it
I
is.
See why.
I've heard that.
No. I mean, I barely felt it. And so anyway, so we pull over, we exchange information, and then, didn't want to turn it into the insurance company because it wasn't that much damage. And I have this guy, Ray, who fixes bumpers.
Okay.
Ray,
the bumper guy.
Ray Flowers is his name. Okay. He's really good at fixing bumpers. And he's fixed my Porsche before. But anyway, so through this transition of, putting Ray and Sean together, we got into a conversation this morning, so he's a new listener. He may be listening right now.
Hey, guy, how you doing?
Yeah.
New friend.
Welcome.
But he's very like-minded as far as, he and his wife both, what's going on in today's world. And I said, because he asked me, what do you do for a living? And so I told him, and he was like, wow, that's really cool. And so I told him a little bit about the show. And he said, oh, my gosh, we need that so much. We really need that right now.
Yes.
And so, so there you go.
That's good. So that's the opposite of road rage, right?
Actually
making a friend during it's what's for some can be one of the most traumatic experiences of their life, getting into a car accident.
Well, you always need to be ladies and gentlemen. Okay.
That is true.
No matter what you're going through, because even if you lose your mind, that's only gonna make it worse. How does that help you in any way?
You may need to say that again for people.
Yeah. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. And it's always good to be a lady or to be a gentleman.
Yes, it is.
And
it's,
so
it's an art that's forgotten. Most definitely.
Yeah. And so we should bring it back.
We could be part of the hashtag movement to bring
chivalry back, right?
Yeah. And it's funny because that was the first thing he asked me is, are you okay? And I said, I'm absolutely fine. You don't have to worry about that. I'm fine, And there's a lot of accidents nowadays. People are texting and driving. I took an oath, and I really, I have in my Subaru now, which is nice. I have the CarPlay.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yes.
And so, and you can text and do everything now. It's just I had a transition,
Yeah. I believe 75 is one of the worst highways in the world. There's always an accident.
And 635.
There's always.
I say 635. That one corridor that we were talking about. There's a part, 20. Everybody knows it, that lives in that area on the east side of Dallas. There's a corridor of 635 in mostly Garland that I swear to God, it is like such a mess over there.
Me and you were in traffic for 2 hours. Last week.
Right.
Because we were on the phone and I'm like, where are you? And she told me the exit. She's I'm like, that's where I am. I've been sitting here for 2 hours.
There's always accidents in that one area.
Yes.
Like every day. I don't know if there's a bunch of people over there that like text and drive, drink and drive, do drugs and drive or
drugs while
like
driving,
seriously,
huh?
Whatever.
Drugs while driving.
I mean, there's always
there
stuff going on there.
Because there's always accidents. Anytime I'm trying to go anywhere out here, unfortunately, even though if I know where I'm going to have to pull up my GPS just to make sure there's no accident along.
I map myself to work every morning because it will tell me the real-time traffic and how long it's going to take me to get there. And it could be 25 minutes. It could be an hour and 5 minutes. Yes.
Right.
No.
Well, people, you know, I get it. Sometimes you get behind. You're in a hurry. But on the road, you really cannot exercise the right that you're in a hurry. It doesn't matter because you may never get there. And worse, you may hurt somebody else.
That is true.
And they may never get there. You may alter a family's life forever by your stupid, reckless driving, thinking that you own the road.
I seen someone shaving, guys.
now,
I've seen makeup before.
Like their
I've
face?
Seen makeup. But I seen someone shaving themselves on the highway.
Did they have shaving cream?
They had shaving cream on and they were going. And I mean, granted, traffic was moving slow, but I'm like, oh my. This person may be used to sitting in traffic that they're shaving.
Focus on one thing at a time.
75. This guy was literally shaving. I said, I've seen it all.
I can't even do makeup. Like, I see. No.
I've powdered
women.
My nose while I'm driving, but I don't look in the mirror. I don't have to look in the mirror.
I have trouble putting on lip gloss while I'm driving.
Yeah.
Or
well, so
gloss.
Everyone out there,
like, wait,
you know,
lip gloss,
Vaseline,
chapstick,
Carmex.
Oh, is it? Are you addicted to Carmex? You know it's addicting, right?
Yes, yes.
It dries your lips out more.
Yes, it does. But I try to use Vaseline more instead of the Carmex. But I have to have something from years of using the Carmex.
Yeah,
unfortunately,
I tried to get off my Burt's Bees.
Yeah, they dry your lips out too.
They do. But I love my pink.
The pink is cute.
The pink, huh?
They made me get a custom lipstick. Not made me. I, of course, went along with it in New York. At the, what was it called? The lip?
Oh, I don't even remember, but it's so cute.
So we got custom made lipstick. Yeah, I think I've used it once.
Custom
I went
made
right
lipstick,
back
huh?
to my, I went right back to, well, you know, you get to pick the color and
you
all
like
that.
You like swatch it
I'm
out.
I'm not a big makeup girl.
Okay.
You know, I just got my eyebrows microbladed, which I absolutely love.
That's awesome.
My eyebrows are back like they used to be.
Okay. All right.
And you don't have to do anything.
I don't have to do anything, and it frames my face so nice. I'm like thrilled. Mm-hmm. I'm thrilled. In fact, she's so good. I think I'm going to put something on our website for anyone looking for like really the best of the best. She is the best of the best. And I think when you're messing with your face, especially your eyebrows, if you're a girl, you need to be careful.
Yeah, those can go south really quick.
It could go sideways.
I've heard.
Oh my gosh. Well, you know, we've got an amazing show coming up today. We do. DeWone, you're going to be talking about common family conflicts. And I thought we were going to talk about sex or something. No.
Well, you know, I think that's a topic that we make and save for a broadcast. Yes.
A podcast after the broadcast. We were going to talk about how much sex is enough sex, right?
Right. How much sex
how
is
How much
next?
Sex should you have? And if this started with Lexi, her boyfriend.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
I was like,
complaining. Complaining that
she's out
of
commission.
It's good. That December is going to be a long month. You're like, dude, but I'm pregnant.
Some people have conflict while they're having sex, right? You know?
Yeah, but the last month, I mean, come on. Give a girl a break. But that's how the whole thing started. So how much sex is normal? How much sex is good? We're going to be talking about that at an upcoming podcast after the broadcast. We're going to record this week. And we've got Jill Lane coming up. She is a pro athlete, health and nutrition coach, and founder of Fueling Champions. We're going to be talking about epigenetics, using your genetics to your advantage. Stay tuned, everyone. You're listening to One Life Radio.
Hi, I'm Ashley Grace, co-founder of HMP Company. Hemp CBD improved my life so much that I started a company to help others naturally feel better. You don't have to have had a severe brain injury like me to benefit from HMP Company products. If you're struggling to feel better, calm your brain, or better deal with daily stress and want to do so naturally, please try HMP Company products. Search HMP Company and use code OLR for 20% off and free shipping. That's HM Company and code OLR to feel better naturally and calm your brain.
This holiday season, give the gift of proper elimination. The modern day toilet is convenient, but it has one major fault. It requires us to sit. While sitting to do our business may be considered civilized, studies show that the natural squat position improves our ability to eliminate. Go to squattypotty.com/onelife for 15% off your entire purchase. Happy holidays to you. Poop, poop, be doo.
Give your body some soul with Sun Warrior's new Soul Good Protein Bars. Sun Warrior is committed to making the best plant-based proteins and superfood supplements from the finest organic ingredients across the globe. Soul Good Bars have an amazing profile. They have 17 to 19 grams of clean organic protein, very low sugar, and 16 to 17 grams of fiber. They're available in delicious flavors like blueberry blast, coconut cashew, cinnamon roll, and salted caramel. Check them out online at sunwarrior.com. That's sunwarrior.com. And give your adventure some soul.
Sun Warrior believes that plants provide the cleanest and most powerful foods, rich in antioxidants, vitamins, minerals, enzymes, and phytonutrients. Our bodies crave real foods, especially in this age where we heavily process everything we eat, stripping out all of the benefits and nutrition well before we have a chance to even use them. Illuminate your body, mind, and the planet with Sun Warrior. To learn more, visit them at sunwarrior.com. That's sunwarrior.com.
Did you know there are over 3,000 kinds of snakes? And most, being shy, pose no threat to humans. But they are still feared and killed, even for frivolous fashion. In his poem Snake, D.H. Lawrence marvels at a snake drinking from a water trough. He succumbs to irrational fear and impulsively throws a log at the very animal he admired moments before. He writes, "And immediately I regretted it. I thought how paltry, how vulgar, what a mean act. I despised myself and the voices of my accursed human education, and I wished he would come back, my snake, for he seemed to me again like a king in exile, uncrowned in the underworld." This is Ingrid Newkirk with Peter, reminding us it's easy to be kind by choosing fake snake over real skin for belts, bags, and shoes.
Whoa! I'm pretending I'm on a Broadway play. Welcome back, everyone, to One Life Radio. That's Kinky Boots, in case you're wondering. What's the name of the soundtrack, Diamond?
Just the original Broadway soundtrack. The song's called Raise You Up.
Raise You Up, that's it. It's a great play if you're in New York. It's only in New York for a couple more months, actually. So if you're there, I would highly encourage you to check it out. Kinky Boots. Anyway, welcome back to One Life Radio. This is Bernadette with Diamond Gray. I've got DeWone Bennett in studio with me, Aviana and Lexi. And Jill Lane is on the line. Jill Lane is a pro athlete, health and nutrition coach, and founder of Fueling Champions, a three-step sports performance and athletic nutrition program built to maximize the potential of student athletes and the parents that support them. You can find her on Instagram at Team Fueling Champions and grab free resources from her website at fuelingchampions.org. Always a pleasure. Jill, how are you doing today?
Always good to be with you, ladies.
Hey,
and
Jill.
Gentlemen. Hey,
and
gentlemen.
Hey, Jill. Miss you. Miss you today.
Well, little Kyle's a little under the weather. He's got a little fever this morning, right?
Yeah, we're pumping in the fluids. He's starting to bounce back. But, you know, the best thing for fever is rest and fluids. So yep. That's what he's getting today.
Yes, and not Pedialyte with sucralose in it, right?
No, ma'am. Not in this house.
Right. Well, you know, I have to tell you, Jill, I was at Herb Mart I went there to get something that I was missing to make quiche last night. And anyway, while I was there, I saw a Diet Hansen's, like diet mm-hmm. soda. And I just picked it up to read the label because I wanted to know what it was sweetened with. And I was shocked that it had sucralose in it.
Yeah, you know, that flew under my radar one time. I thought, oh, Hansen's, it's a quote, natural soda. I'm going to, just, you know, assuming that they were using a quote, natural sweetener in their products, grabbed some one time. And when I got home, I was really bummed to see that myself. And we're going to be talking a little about genetics and something we know about sucralose, at least in some animals.